Good morning, this is sexologist Dr. Dave, and I welcome you to the next video of sexuality class. Our topic initially was why should we study sexuality, and today we are going to discuss the fifth reason why we should study sexuality, and that is it leads to growth of intimacy and sexual satisfaction in our lives. Now, first of all, let's try to understand what is the meaning of intimacy and how does intimacy form a part of overall loving any human being. When we talk about intimacy, we talk about either two men or two women, or a man and a woman when they can share their secrets, when they can share their vulnerabilities, they can share their deepest sexual secrets with each other, confide in each other. That is when we say that the couple is very, very intimate. So, the knowledge of sex will actually make a couple very intimate. To give you a small example, let's say a couple has an idea of what are sexual fantasies. And let's say we take a case where a man and a woman, before making love, they are discussing their sexual fantasies. This is definitely going to make their bond much more intimate. Now, this was a brief definition about intimacy, but let's see the wider implication of having knowledge of human sexuality. Of course, human sexuality is not only about sex and sex, it is also about love. So love is a part of sex. And what does love comprise of? Love comprises of intimacy, passion and commitment. I've already spoken about what is intimacy. Talking about passion, passion is the physical manifestation of sexual intercourse, the desire. And then we have commitment, commitment towards the partner whom you love. So if you have a clear understanding of love, and if you can develop all these components of intimacy, passion and commitment in your life, then love is present in your life, and who is responsible for that? It is the knowledge of human sexuality. Again, when it comes to sexual satisfaction, now you may be wondering, why do you need the knowledge of human sexuality to get sexual satisfaction? After all, isn't sexual satisfaction all about ejaculating inside a woman, and isn't that what satisfaction is all about? Or just for a woman to orgasm, isn't that satisfaction all about? But listeners, let me tell you something. Sexuality is something very, very broad, and vaginal intercourse is a very small part of human sexuality. It is just one way of expressing your love. So again, coming back to human sexuality and sexual satisfaction, if you have basic knowledge of human sexuality, you could learn techniques of satisfying your partner inside the bedroom and outside the bedroom. Now, of course, you must be wondering, how do you satisfy your partner outside the bedroom? Now, this is a very, very important question, especially for women. The happier she is outside the bedroom, the more happy she will be inside the bedroom, which means you need to show a lot of physical affection to a woman throughout the course of the day for her to be ready to make love at night. Now, if you have this basic knowledge of women's psyche, and how can that knowledge be gained? Only by basic knowledge of human sexuality, then you stand a much better chance of giving sexual satisfaction to your partner. Again, control of premature ejaculation. One of the complaints which many women have when they come to me for consultation is that their partners come up very soon and they are left dissatisfied. Again, if the wife has a basic knowledge of male sexual physiology, her complaint would probably turn into some kind of a joint effort to work with her husband's problem. So it's very, very important that when you are reading a book on human sexuality, I would say both the man and the wife should read it together, have a good discussion about it. It's not something which only the man reads or the woman reads. It is a joint responsibility of both the partners to read a proper book on human sexuality and discuss whatever they want to discuss after reading. Even something like how women can reach orgasm. Of course, there are many reasons why women do not reach orgasm, but of course there are many ways in which women can reach orgasm, and by a simple knowledge of human sexuality, she could reach orgasm as and when she wants. So this was a brief video about the need of studying sexuality. If you found it useful, do like, share and comment, and please share it with your friends so they could also be more intimate with their partners and also be more satisfied with their own sex lives. Thank you very much.